Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Raspberry Pi. In this video, we will see how can we multiplex the serial port of Raspberry Pi to connect multiple devices. For this, I am going to use CD4053 and in the programming language side, I am going to use Java. This is not the only way to have like multiple serial ports in Raspberry Pi. And you can certainly connect some USB to UART converters to the Pi and have multiple ports. However, this is just another way of doing so. You can use this method with any other microcontrollers also, like Arduino and so. The limitation though is the baud rate cannot go higher than 115200. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, this is the multiplexer module that I am having over here, and this is not a true UART multiplexer, but it is actually a CD4053 triple two channel analog MUX and DMUX IC. So it pretty much support from input to output as well as output to input, you can say, because it is a MUX DMUX, so it can have two way communication. So it can be used for RX as well as TX lines. So you can see over here, this is the pretty much functional block diagram and the pins of the particular IC that they have used, and you can see over here there are three blocks of this MUX and DMUX with two channels each. So what they have done is they have not used not exposed actually one channel of that, and they have only exposed one selection line, and based on that the communication will happen. So I think they have pulled one pin high or something, and they are making zero and on. That again I need to check the particular schematic, but I'm not sure of, but that is that how they have done. Again, I'll attach the data sheet of this particular IC, so if you are going to use raw one you can use so. And coming to different pins, it has got three selection pins, then three sets of three pins for this input and output. So you can check out from the schematic, or you can see over here also wire pins and chat pin that goes from 1, 2, and 3. So that's all. With that, it has got an enable pin and one VCC, ground, and VE pin. So over here on the chip or the module I have got, it has got ground, VCC, selection, RX-TX, that is from the Pi that we are going to use, then ground RX-TX pair, then ground RX-TX pair. There are a couple of RX-TX pairs that you can connect to external devices from the Raspberry Pi. So that's all with the module itself. And what I'm going to do is I'll be connecting this module to the Pi like this, and I'll be having these two USB to UART bridges, and I'll be connecting it to the module itself, and I'll be connecting these modules or this USB to UART bridge to the PC, so that we can have data out of the Pi to either of the ports, and that will be again selected by the program itself and it will be shown in the PC. So I'll quickly connect these mail headers to this particular module over here, and we'll have some jumpers connected to the Pi as well as the USB to UART bridge, and we'll get back to PC and we'll see how the code is going to work. So let's quickly connect and we'll check out the code. So guys, before getting into the code, let's once again check this particular IC that I have used and the module that I am having. What they've done is, like, they've connected this S1 and S2 and exposed it as an control input. So what happens is, if this particular pins pulled high, the 1Z and 2Z gets connected to 1A1 and 2Y1 respectively. So whenever it goes low, the 1Y0 and 2Y0 gets connected to 1Z and 2Z. So making it kind of a multiplexer for like RX and the TX pin. So that again I have told you earlier, so I'll not get into that. I just wanted to clarify about the module that I have used. So let's open up the code, and over here I'm using Eclipse in my system to develop the code. And coming to the library, I have used Py4j, and that language, as I said earlier, it is Java. So Py4j is the library that let you access GPIO pins of Raspberry Pi using Java. So if you are not aware of this, you can check my earlier tutorials, like how to develop around it, and like specifically how to use Java development in Raspberry Pi. So here's the code that I've used. So the basic thing is, we just need to control the control pin that is being exposed from the module itself. So we need to just make it high or low. So therefore I have just defined a function over here, send data, that takes data and the port that you want to send the data in. And depending on the port value, either it is 1 or something else, it makes the selector pin high or low. Then what it does is, prior to this, what it does is just flash the serial registers and all, so that if you're having some data in your input register or something, in a prior session and all, it will get flushed. Then there's a delay, and after that, it just put the string data that we are providing. Again, you can modify the code if you are sending something else depending upon your requirement. Then we have added a 1 second delay, so that it will have enough time for the connected device to process the command. Let's say if you are sending, then it checks if something response is available from the connected device. Then after that, it just process the data and output as a, or returns it as a string. Getting into the main code, over here I have written some initialization code. So it takes GPIO controller. We have just initialized the selector pin that we have connected to the module itself. Then we are opening up the serial port. Now if it is not able to open, it will just print out unable to open serial port. Then in a loop, we are just printing out hello world to port 0 and hello world 1 to port 1. So it goes on in a loop with a 2 second delay in between. So the main thing is before dumping the code into Raspberry Pi, make sure you have enabled the serial port of Raspberry Pi. And if you are using a newer version of Raspberry Pi, the actual hardware port is being used by the Bluetooth module that is on board. So you need to disable that if you want to access the complete features of the hardware serial port. So you can do that pretty much. I'm not getting into that, and if you have not, you can check my earlier video, for which I'll provide the link down below in the description. Now I'll just need to compile this code once to generate a runnable jar file that will transfer to the Raspberry Pi. So before that, let me just open an SCP session to Pi. Yep, over here I am having a session to Pi. I'll just delete this earlier uploaded jar file and the respective libraries and all. Now let's have a SSH connection to the Pi. Yep, you can see over here. Now after compiling once, I'll just export it as runnable char file. So make sure to select this one. Again, if you are new to this, make sure to check my earlier video on this. So I'll just browse the location, not an issue. Click on finish. Yep, and overwrite. And over here you can see, okay, let's open up the folder itself where I have exported. Yep, you can see uart.jar file and uart_leaf. So this folder particularly contains all the libraries or external jar files that we have used for the project. So I'm just going to upload all this into the Pi desktop. So before getting like running the application itself, let's open up the serial ports that I have connected to the Pi. So I'm over here using couple of like FTDI modules. Those are 3.3 volt compatible. So you can use pretty much any like USB to serial adapter that you are having. So over here as serial port monitor, I'm using this Arduino serial monitor. By choosing different serial ports and all. Get another instance of this for the other port. Yep, these are the two serial ports that I have connected to the Pi. Now let's run the application and we'll see if it is having the outputs in the serial port monitor. So again, if I have used Arduino to simply like show the like data out of the Pi, but you can use any serial port application like some Teraterm or like that. So I'll just run the application. To run that, sudo java /uart.jar. Okay, I have not properly configured the baud rate. What I have used in application, that is 9600. Yep, you can see over here hello world one coming up. Okay, for some reason I'm not getting, yeah, you can see over here it is printing out hello world 0, and over here it is showing the output whatever like type over here, or it basically response from the device. So if you want to manipulate the like output from the device or kind of input to the Raspberry Pi, you can do so over here. So like send data returns the data that is being fetched from the device. So that's pretty much all about it, like what is happening. Again, the customization depends upon your application. This is just like a demonstration of what can be done. Again, the setup that I have done for this Pi is pretty much limited. Like one limitation is, unless until you are pulling data out of the connected device, you are not going to get like data to your Pi, because we are just like selecting the serial port over here. So there is nothing like listener and all that you can use. But if you want to have that like feature in your application, you need to like switch the serial port real fast and implement the serial port listener that comes with Pi 4J. Again, that will be a bit complex considering. Or you can like send like have some interrupts from your device to particular GPIO pin of Raspberry Pi whenever the device wants to send data. In that way, you can control the particular selector pin and you can have your data onto the Pi itself. So that's the limitation that comes with. And that's all, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this video, or somehow it will be useful for your projects. So if you have liked it, consider hitting the like button, and if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, consider subscribing it. So see you next time with our next video. Till then, goodbye.